My name is Michelle and I'm here to talk to all the Windows users about how to add a page break to a document. Let's use this document up on the screen here as an example. As you may notice, I have a paragraph and then I have a bibliography underneath. However, the bibliography starts on the first page but finishes on the second page. Now many people in this situation would simply hit the Enter key several times in order to get the bibliography onto the next page. However, what they do not realize is that they can run into several problems if they do this. What if I were to add text to the following paragraph above? Or what if I were to delete text? It would obviously affect the placement of my page break, right? This is exactly the reason why we have to add a page break to the document before we decide to add or delete text. Take a minute and look at this bibliography again. If you may notice, it starts on the first page but ends on the second page. Now, in order to add a page break to this document but not force it to be there, is simply clicking before the B, going to your Insert tab, and under your Pages group, I want you to select the page break option. If you notice, your bibliography now is all on the same page. The first step is a page break in the middle of a paragraph. Take a second and look up at the document I have here. As you notice, the paragraph beginning with once begins on the first page but ends on the second page. Now, in order to get this paragraph onto the next page, I do not want you to simply hit the Enter key a few times in order to do so, because if you do that, you will run into several problems. Instead, however, I want you to place your cursor right before the letter O, go to your Page Layout tab, and under Paragraph Dialog Box Launcher, I want you to select the Line and Page Breaks tab. Then, I want you to select the Keep Lines Together option and hit OK. As you notice, your paragraph is now all on the same page. The next type is adding a page break between paragraphs. As you can see, there is a heading here that says Observations, but the supporting text is on the next page. In order to get this observation title onto the next page, I want you to place your cursor before the letter O. Go to your Page Layout tab, and under your Parallel Dialog Box Launcher, I want you to select the Line and Page Breaks tab. Then, I want you to select the Keep with Next option and hit OK. As you can see, the observation title is now on the other page with its supporting text. The next type is a page break before a paragraph. In order to do this, I'm going to place my cursor after the word me and after the period. Then I'm going to go to my Page Layout tab, and under my Paragraph Dialog Box Launcher, I'm going to select the Line and Page Breaks tab. Then I'm going to select the Page Break Before option and hit OK. As you can see, the paragraph now moved to the next page. Congratulations, you are now experts on page breaks.